Hello, it's Keith here, and welcome to the Hello World series of my 6502 assembly programming tutorials. This time we're going to be looking at the VIC-20. We're going to learn how to make a very simple Hello World example on the VIC-20 and get it running. Now, we're going to be doing this as a PRG file and also as a cartridge. I think the cartridge might be more useful to you because that gives you more system memory. We're going to look at both though. We're going to learn how to actually get it running, and that should give you a good place to get started with your own programming. Anyway, let's have a look at the code and let's actually see the program in action. So this is what we're going to be running today, and let's just fire it up here. I need to select my VIC-20 here. We'll just start with a regular program. So you can see we've just printed Hello World to the screen just here. So it's pretty straightforward. Let's actually see the code that was doing that job though. So at the start of our program, we've got a header here. This is the code that we need to actually get our program to run from BASIC. And we're not going to look at the details of it here because, as I say, this is a good template for you to use in your program. I think it's about as good as it can be. So that's what we're going to be using here to get a valid program to start. We're going to be using a function here, FFD2, to print a character to the screen here. Now, in this case, we don't have a lowercase character set. And so here what we're doing is we're checking if the character is above 96. And if it's not, we're branching over here. But if it is, we're having to convert the lowercase characters to uppercase here. And we're doing that by clearing bit 5 of the character that we're selecting here. This is designed to run with the accumulator specifying the character we want to show. So that will convert our characters to uppercase, and that will allow us to print strings to the screen. Now, when it comes to printing strings to the screen, I use a common piece of code in all of my tutorials. It uses a character 255 terminated string that comes from the original Chibi Akuma's game. And so you can see here, we're loading the address of Hello World into zero page entries 20 and 21 here. We're then loading in a character from the zero page 20 here, offset by the Y register. And we're just running those all through the print to character routine here until we get to a character 255. And that's the end of the string. So this here will just print the Hello World message to the screen that is defined just here. And then we've got a new line here, which is just a character 13 sent to the screen. So that's pretty straightforward here. And that's how we can run from BASIC. Now, of course, that's just our source code. We do need to see the actual assembling file here. And here it is. Now, this is going to compile our standard program file. You can see we're specifying a CBMPRG because VASM actually understands this program format. We need to specify our file to assemble here. It's marked as %1 because this is a batch file, but that would be your file.asm effectively. We're defining a few other options here. We're specifying to check labels. This makes sure we've not accidentally put a command with no tabs at the left-hand side of the screen because the system wouldn't detect that as a label. But if you've got a label that's the same as a command, it is probably a mistake. So that will warn us. Disabling case sensitivity. I'm defining a couple of symbols on the command line. This VASM one is not needed. I use that in case I need to work with multiple assemblers. Sometimes you'll have conditional code that only works on one assembler. I've got a VIC definition here, which you might need for the monitor we're going to look at in a moment. I'm outputting a listing file, which is a debugging tool. Very handy there, that listing file. Shows what each line of the code compiles to in assembly. And then we're outputting a binary file. You can see I'm specifying fbin here. And here's the name of the file we're outputting. We're outputting program.prg here, and the O switch defines that. Now, once we've created our program, assuming there were no errors, you can see I'm just checking that here, then we need to start it with our emulator. We're using VICE, and so we start with XVIC here, and we just specify the program.prg. And that's all I did to get the example running today. It's pretty straightforward, really. Most of it's just working out the code. So as I say, it's certainly worth trying. And you can download all of these example code and all of the tools and scripts that I used in today's example from my website. So hopefully that'll make things a little bit easier for you. Okay, so we've looked there at how to actually compile the PRG file, but we also want to see how to compile a cartridge. And this is especially useful for the VIC because the VIC has very little memory, so you might want to save some memory by using a program, which is a cartridge, which is a ROM, and it's outside of the RAM area, leaving all the RAM for your code to actually use for variables and for graphics and things. So that's certainly something I'd suggest you consider. Now, the cartridge header is pretty simple. We start as A000, and we just need a program start and a reset vector here and a sort of predefined header here. So you can just use this as is. It should make a nice little template for you. If you're using a ROM cartridge though, that means you've bypassed BASIC, and that means your screen won't be set up. Now, the easiest way to get things set up on the VIC that I've found is to use these options here. We're initializing the system RAM here, restoring the kernel vectors, initializing the IO with these two commands here, and that should get things running enough for you for this example. And then we're just loading our hello world in here. That's not needed. I don't know why that's in there. And everything else is the same, I think. So now this version is actually an extended version with the monitor tools. There is a normal PRG version. We'll just look at that just here. The monitor tools are something that I use to actually do debugging when I'm getting started with the system. And the idea is here that you will be able to learn how a system is working by looking at the state of registers and dumping parts of the memory. So you could maybe read in a byte from a piece of hardware and see if what's being output, for example, reading in a joystick, you want to see what the data from that joystick looks like. And having a way of seeing the registers will help out with that. Dumping parts of memory is great if your program's malfunctioning. Maybe your zero page entries have got changed. Maybe your program's not even loaded into the memory address you thought it was. Maybe you've made some kind of mistake there. So I'd say that that's quite handy. I'm not going to go into how those actually work, but for using them, all you do is you run monitor to see the state of the registers, or memdump to show an address and a number of lines to export. And that has been built into this cartridge example here. So let's fire that up and let's see that cartridge example running. I just need to specify VIC ROM here, this alternate batch file here. And you can see here our hello world message, this time with no basic initialization. You can see the registers here, A, X, Y, the stack, the flags, and the program counter, the current running address. And you can see that makes sense. A028 is the current running address. And our cartridge started at A000 here. So that kind of makes sense. And then here, it's got a bit confused, but here is the dump of the memory. And you can see the 3000 range is filled with all 30s for some reason. It looks like zeros. This is the ASCII being output here. So hopefully, between these programs, you've got a good starting point to see how to make your own code. And with the monitor tools, maybe that'll help you out if you're learning and things aren't working right, which of course they often don't. Now, we do need a different assembly file for that ROM file. Let's see that here. Now, you can see we've got no CBM prog. We had a CBM prog option before. That's now gone because we're not creating a program file. And apart from that, I think everything else is the same. Now, the only thing is once we've built the binary file, we then have to actually pad it out. I'm padding it out to 8 kilobytes here. I'm using a program called Binary Tools. This is a program I wrote myself in C#. You can download it from my website with all of the other development tools. And this is creating the cartridge to the correct size for the emulator. We then started up with the XVIC, which is part of the VICE set. And we're specifying cartridge and we're specifying the file here. And that's all it really takes to build a cartridge. And as I say, this is something I think you're going to want to consider, because when I was writing Grime 6502, it was too big to run from a prog file. So I think a cartridge is probably going to be the way you want to look at doing things. And hopefully this is a good, easy way to get started making a cartridge file. So there we go. That's what we're going to be looking at today. That's how you can create your own cartridge and how to create your own program file and just get some text to the screen. Now, if you want to see more action on the VIC, I've got loads of other videos already on my website, so please have a look around my YouTube channel to see the VIC playlist for the VIC videos. Anyway, if you're not a subscriber to this channel, please like and subscribe, because it really helps keep my motivation up. As you can guess, it takes a lot of work to create all these tutorials, and so I'd say it really is a big motivator for me. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this, and I hope you'll enjoy programming the VIC-20 and enjoy making your own content on it. Anyway, thanks for watching today, and goodbye.